back. It's time for our movie night. I've got the snacks ready. All right, what's the movie?
Or I will never see her again.
This is a long movie. How long does it go for? 5 hours? I gotta get out of here. I'm just getting a glass of water from the kitchen. Whoa! This gummy bear doubled in size when added to water. No time for movies. We need to find out how this happens. Are you ready? Then let's get scienced. Today, we'll be doing the gummy bear experiment. To do this at home, you'll need 4 cups, water, salt, sugar, and of course, some gummy bears. I found the Haribo brand of gummy bears works well for this experiment. Let's start by making a sugar solution. First, add 1 cup or 250 mils of room temperature water to a small saucepan or bowl. Then add 500 grams of sugar and stir for 10 minutes. Some of the sugar might not dissolve, but that's okay. It means you've made a saturated solution. Next, we'll make a salt solution. Add 1 cup or 250 mils of room temperature water to another small saucepan or bowl. Then add 100 grams of salt and stir for 10 minutes. Like the sugar solution, some of the salt might not dissolve. Now that we've got everything ready, it's time to start the experiment. Choose 4 gummy bears that are the same color and measure their height and width. These gummy bears are all 2.1 centimeters high and 1.1 centimeters wide. If you have a set of scales, record the weight of each gummy bear. These gummy bears each weighed 2.3 grams. Set up 4 glasses and add a label to each one. We have the water, the sugar solution, the salt solution, and the control. Then add 1 cup of water, 1 cup of the sugar solution, and 1 cup of the salt solution to these glasses, and leave the control empty. Carefully add 1 gummy bear face up to each glass and cover the glasses with clear wrap. And that's it. We now need to wait for 48 hours, though you'll probably start seeing them get bigger within a few hours. Lucky for you, I prepared 4 other samples 2 days earlier, so let's see what they look like. The control gummy bear looks the same as before. It's still 2.1 centimeters high, 1.1 centimeters wide, and weighs 2.3 grams. The gummy bear from the water is now massive. It's 4.3 centimeters high, 2.5 centimeters wide, and weighs 11.6 grams. The gummy bear from the sugar solution also got bigger. It's 2.3 centimeters high, 1.3 centimeters wide, and weighs 2.9 grams. The gummy bear from the salt solution got smaller. It's now 2 centimeters high, 1 centimeter wide, and weighs 1.54 grams. The gummy bears could get bacteria on them when you touch them with your hands, which can then grow during this experiment, so it's best not to eat them. So what's happening? A gummy bear is made by heating a mixture of sugar, corn syrup, and water, and adding gelatin, colors, and flavors. Gelatin molecules are usually bundled and coiled up. We can think of them a bit like these lights. When heated, they stretch out and move around each other more easily, acting like a liquid. We can see this by heating some gummy bears in the microwave. The heat makes them act like a liquid. Whoa! When they cool down, the long gelatin molecules start to bundle up again. They tangle around other gelatin molecules and hold each other together. The gummy bear now acts a bit more like a solid, while still being squishy and stretchy. And those gummy bears from the microwave? That puddle has now cooled down and turned back into a squishy and stretchy solid. If we zoom into a gummy bear, we'd see lots of gaps between the gelatin molecules, just like the gaps between these strands of light. These gaps trap water and sugar molecules. Why is this important? In one of my first videos, where I showed you how to make a bouncy egg, we learnt about osmosis. Osmosis is the process in which water moves across a membrane to the side that has the most chemicals dissolved in it. When the gummy bear is added to water, there are more chemicals inside the gummy bear So water moves into the gummy bear to try to balance things out. The strong but flexible gelatin molecules stretch and the bear gets bigger as it fills with water. It's a bit like these water balloons filling up.
Simon, I'm home.
Hey! Unlike other candies, like lollipops, gelatin doesn't dissolve in room temperature water. So the gummy bear grows while staying the shape of a bear. Notice I said it doesn't dissolve in room temperature water. If the water gets too hot, then it can dissolve. The gummy bear placed in sugar water doesn't grow as much as the one in plain water. That's because there's not too much difference between the amount of sugar in the gummy bear and the amount of sugar in the water. Not as much water needs to move into the gummy bear to balance things out. The gummy bear placed in salt water shrunk and became smaller than a regular gummy bear. That's because there was a lot of salt dissolved in the water, and so water needed to move out of the gummy bear and into the salt water to try to balance things out. You can also try adding other liquids to the glass, like vinegar or vegetable oil, to see what happens to the gummy bear. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time on Silly Science with Simon.